talented, sexy, groundbreaking, a phenomenon. Today I'm lucky enough to meet the man himself. Come with me and enter the world of Mr. Craig David. Craig, may I first say it's an honour to meet you, and thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us today.
Don't worry about it, Kate. Craig David is happy to speak to you on a Monday, on a Tuesday, on a Wednesday, on a Thursday, on a Friday, and a Saturday, but not on Sunday because I'm chilling 7 days. Rewind, more selector.
As the album says, you were obviously born to do it. But when did it first become apparent that you were vocally gifted?
Probably at primary school, I think. Craig David, what about six then? I just landed role of baby Jesus in school play, like. And then that was first time I properly got respected as an R&B artist. My name's Jesus, check it out, alright. I'm king of Jews, I'd like to say thanks for all gold, donkeys, frankincense and all that. It's proper bowl.
Now, Craig, your rise to fame has been meteoric over the past year. Have you had time at all to sit back and maybe reflect upon your success?
To be honest, Kate, Craig David thinks his success has been quite mind-blowing. Because you've got to understand, I came from note me. I used to live on a council estate, and look at me now. It's its council estate that I grew up on. Rough as fuck, I tell thee. Proper like Bronx. Not that I've been to Bronx, but you see it on telly, don't you? I'm glad I don't live here no more. I've got a big house with crazy paving outside, just had a porch built. Me mate John did all this crazy paving. It's bus selector. It's not just up front, it goes round back as well. And I've even got a fucking soda stream. All this, and I'm only 19 years old, you know what I mean? It's proper bus selector, I tell thee. Rewind, 7 days.
So what was Craig David the child like then?
Well, I was like any other child, really. Except I had a beard and a fuck-off chin.
So do you think that that affected your childhood, Craig?
To be honest with you, Kate, I think it did, I was bullied at school, I was beaten up in the street, I properly had the shit kicked out of me. But it did have its perks, though, having a beard. I could get cider and fags when I was 7, but time I was 9, I was going out with a 28-year-old. She were a proper beau. Craig David.
One more time, please, a little bit off-key there.
Craig David.
Just slightly off. Once more, please.
Craig David. That was fucking right, that one. It was spot on.
Now, Craig, I understand, and not a lot of people know this, but you're, in fact, a massive bird lover. Is that right?
No. I hate fat lasses. They take up too much room and they stink.
No. When I say massive bird lover, I mean of the flying variety.
Oh, aye, Kate. I fucking love birds that fly. I've got me own. She's called Kez. She's a peregrine falcon. I got her from a man in Huddersfield who's got a dog with one leg. She's beautiful. Kez, come on, you bastard. Kez! 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 Come on, Kez, you bastard. There she goes. She talks and everything. Do you want me to get her out for you?
Why not?
Will do.
Why not?
Come on, Kez, you bastard. She's beautiful.
Yeah.
Kate, look at the way she just sits there.
Very graceful.
She's beautiful, isn't she?
Yeah.
Come on, Kez. Say something for Kate. Kez, say something for Kate.
What does she say normally?
She says pamphlet. She'll say cream. All sorts.
Right.
Come on, Kez, you bastard. Say something. I'll get rid of you. Buy myself a leopard. Kez, little bastard, say something! Proper bastard.
Join me next time when Craig will be talking openly about his sex life.
It went all over her face.
His parents.
Used to get into bed with us most nights because he used to piss his own.
And his early DJing career.
When I said bo, they said selector.
Until then. Now, if you were to be approached in the street and someone were to say to you, bo, you would automatically reply, selector. Why? Well, it's all down to this next man. At 19, he is fast becoming the face of British R&B. DJing in the clubs in and around Southampton with Mark Hill from
the Mark. Hi, Mark. How's it going? That rash gone? Brilliant.
Would you say that the days of Craig David the DJ are behind us?
Well and truly, Kate. Although I have to say, DJing was a big part of my life. It was here where I played my first gig. This place to me is like cabin to Beatles. I remember it like it were yesterday. I played here on a Monday, I played here on a Tuesday, I played here on a Wednesday, played here on a Thursday, I played here on a Friday and Saturday, but not on Sunday, because I was fucking knackered.
I think Craig David is one of our best and most talented new performers. I mean, even though he lost out of the Brits, I actually don't think that matters. I know a lot of musicians are now looking up to him, you know, as the kind of face of the future. And also, I know a lot of kids now are probably asking their parents to buy them a Peregrine Falcon. Have you seen this Falcon? It's beautiful. It's trained and everything.
Now, Craig, you've got 6 nominations at this year's Brit Awards. How does it feel to get so much recognition at such a young age and to be talked about, really, as the next Stevie Wonder?
Well, to be spoken of in the same sentence as Stevie Wonder is a proper privilege for Craig David. I always wanted to be like him when I were a child. Didn't want to be blind, though. You can fuck that shit. Imagine problems poor bugger has when he's on bog. I bet he gets done off his mum all the time for pissing on seat. And as for Brits, what can I say? 6 nominations, but no Brit for CD.
That must be a real bone of contention for you, because...
Bone of contention? It's a bummer he didn't get out. But I had a good night, you know. I met him, those pop stars, and that fat one thinks he fancied me. Nolly, he had his hands round me. I think he's a bit fruity, him. Check it out, 7 days! Rewind! Or eat!
So what does bow selector actually mean?
Kate, bow selector can mean anything. You can say it when you're happy. Bow selector! I've won a tenner! You can say it when you're angry. Oh, bow selector! Or you can say it for no reason at all. Bow selector, there, I just said it. Didn't mean out. Just tighten me balls up at front, will you? No problem.
Craig's been coming here about 10 years now. He always comes to me because I always do the best job, you see. But he's always had the same hair.
That's right. I tried down road, but they only put 105 balls on my head. I like 115, don't I?
All the time.
Now that you are the face of British R&B, I can only imagine that trying to walk around unrecognised is pretty much impossible for you these days.
He can be a proper bastard. Sometimes Craig David has to wear a disguise. Don't get me wrong, I'm not moaning. It's great when fans come up to me in the street and ask me for my autograph. But when people come up to me and threaten to punch me fucking lights out, spit in my face and call me big-chinned bearded bastard, it's not so great. Bow selector.
So who would you say has had the biggest influence on you in terms of your career?
Oh, it's got to be my mother. She always believed in me. Whilst most people were taking piss out of me chin and me beard when I was 6 years old with a fucking beard, you know what I mean? She was always behind me.
I used to say to him, Craig, if you can spend as much time on your own work as you can designing your bloody beards, you'll be a genius. Look, these are his old school books, full of pictures of beards. All I wanted for him was to have a good education and to stop pissing his bed.
What are you telling him that for? He said you weren't going to mention it about pissing bed. Bull selector.
Do you still have a problem with your bladder?
What are you saying, like?
Well, in reference to what your mother said, I mean, do you still wet the bed?
What did I say?
What?
I said I'd do an interview if you didn't ask me about pissing bed.
What?
Didn't I? Get this mic off me. That's the interview's over.
But
nice to meet you,
but
Kate.
Your mum said...
Well done, get off. Can you get this mic off me? You can fucking edit that bit out as well. Here, John, they're asking me about pissing bed in here. I'm not having that.